I mean, I want to take a sip, but it's really hot right now. Yes, it's really hot and I'm losing all of my lip gloss. Before I'm gonna start this video, I want to clarify that this video is all about my own opinion about this book. I think pretty much everyone who started their like BookTube community career or who are basically involved in the BookTube community know Christine from PolandBananasBooks. I've been watching her since I first found out about BookTube, and in the past couple of years, I haven't really followed her like that intensely, but I watch her videos every now and then and I really like them. I really like Christine. She is such a quirky, fun person, so I have completely nothing against her. I'm just gonna share my honest opinion about her book again, but better. Today, I'm gonna spill the tea, because I have my tea right here, about the book that Christine Riccio, aka PolandBananas, the biggest booktuber here on YouTube, wrote. This is the book, a beautiful, super cute cover, and first of all, I'm gonna talk like a little bit about the basics, when this book came out, what the plot is, etc., etc. Then I will go into this book with non-spoilery thoughts about the plot and like what I thought about that, and then I'm gonna go deep into spoilery sections on this book. I have so many opinions, mostly not positive, and I feel like it's gonna maybe give me some controversy or like, I don't know. That's why I put a little disclaimer in front of the video, because I'm not here trying to convince you to think negatively about this book whatsoever. These are just my thoughts and my opinions about Again But Better. It has nothing to do with like a personal attack on the author or something. It's just, I feel alone with my opinion and I need to share it, and then maybe other people will come forward with their opinion as well. I have the basic information here on Goodreads, so I'm gonna read that from my phone. So Again But Better is a YA book written by Christine Riccio, the biggest booktuber here on YouTube. As of recording this video, she has 406,000 subscribers. The book was published May 7th, 2019. It has 373 pages, and on Goodreads, it has a 3.92 out of 5 stars, which is really high. That's like almost an 8 out of 10. And my rating is a 2 out of 5. So it's quite a bit lower than that. Just a quick synopsis. This book is about Shane, our main character. She is 20 years old, just like I am right now. Back in 2011, she's going to study abroad in London. She is a pre-med student, but she doesn't really feel like that's her passion. And she's always been obsessed with reading books and writing stories. And she is gonna follow like a writing course in London for a couple of months. It's all about her wanting to redo her full college experience, because back in the States, she has not really done anything special. She's been in her dorm so many times. She doesn't really have any friends. She goes back home every single weekend. She decided to go abroad to sort of like redo college, start it all over, make friends, kiss boys, just travel, do whatever she really likes that she has never done before. And when she arrives in London, she starts to find out that it's a lot harder than she thought that it was gonna be. So this synopsis really grabbed my attention because it totally sounds like me in a book. I'm a 20-year-old. I do sometimes feel like I'm doing university kind of in like the wrong way. I'm also home quite a lot, but I'm just having a lot of fun with also my friends back at home, and then also doing things in Utrecht. It's just that I felt like I could really start to relate to Shane. So right now, let's go into my non-spoilery thoughts about this book. I've written down like all of my thoughts here on this sheet. Okay, just I need to take a little sip. So Shane is a 20-year-old girl, and I feel like Shane read more like a 14-year-old. She snorts all the time instead of just laughing, and she does it like so often. I feel like every 2 or 3 pages, she snorts at least one time. She is also one of the most clumsy characters that I've ever read, until a point where it's just not realistic anymore. For instance, I think she dropped her chair like 10 times in this book, like probably even more, and I was like, you know that you do this very often. Why can't you just kind of like keep in mind that when you sit on a chair, okay, maybe I shouldn't like pull it back so hard. It happened so often that it was just like annoying me so much. I know that there are tons of people who are clumsy. I mean, I'm clumsy too, but Shane was just clumsy to the max. I've never met someone as clumsy as her. Also, something that I really, really do not like about this book, and this is not really a spoiler because this is from page 30 on. Shane is obsessed with this boy that she meets back in London called Pilot from the moment she meets him, and it's just like, I hate this in books so much when the main character just kind of like falls in love instantly with this character. I feel like it's so unrealistic. Maybe this is also because I do not fall in love easily myself. Shane is obsessed with Pilot from the moment she sees him in their kitchen. She hasn't even talked to them and she's already like, oh my god, swoon. And that doesn't change for like the rest of the book. I cannot stand it when that happens. You don't even know a person, you haven't talked to them, and you're already obsessed with them. I don't know if you guys believe in love at first sight, but I don't. It's just something that annoyed me from the moment that I read this book, and it was then that I thought, shit, this is not what I signed up for. The first like 10 or 20 pages of the book, I felt like, okay, this might go in a good direction, and then I started to notice that those kinds of things I really didn't like about it. I'm gonna go into more detail about Shane's parents in more of like the spoilery section, but all that I can say in the non-spoilery section is that they are super, what we want is what you're gonna do, and that is something that I cannot imagine a ton of parents doing to their children. I know that there are parents who do, and especially more in like non-Western cultures, people are still very much into like family traditions, but in a Western world, it's something that I'm like, ah. Something that I noticed in this book as well is that Shane never shares her feelings. Even when she is feeling like crap and people give her the opportunity to talk about this, when they're like, Shane, are you okay? Shane, what's going on? How is this in your life? How is that in your life? She's just like, I'm fine. The complete opposite of how I am an open book. I talk about people about basically everything if they make me feel comfortable. Shane is such a closed book. She keeps everything to herself. Constantly, I was screaming to the book like, Shane, talk to people, please. It would solve so many problems. Every time there was a certain confrontation and she had to confront the confrontation, she didn't do it. She either walked away, ran away, or just didn't talk about it. And it's something that I'm like, girl, help yourself, please. I mean, I know that this book is like all based on Christine's experiences as well. And if I would write a book, I have a certain idea for like a book that I would want to write. It's also based on my personal experiences. Shane resembled Christine so incredibly much. She also has a blog which is called French Watermelon 19. Christine's YouTube channel is called PolandBananasBooks. They both resembled a country. They both resembled like a fruit. I was like, okay, this is a little too much. I know Christine is obsessed with Taylor Swift. Shane is obsessed with Taylor Swift. There was a lot of talk about things which were super popular back in the 2010s, which I did really like. Like things like Angry Bird and iPods. I could not compare the two to each other, which I don't think is like a bad thing per se. I didn't want to compare the story that was written in this book to the booktuber, like the author who wrote this story. But because of all these resemblances, I couldn't like not compare them, kind of. The last thing that I wanted to mention in like the non-spoilery section about this book is that all of the side characters, which are Shane's friends that we get to know, we only know them in like a very basic way. We only know what they look like and just a couple of things like what they are doing in London in university there. I couldn't really tell you what any of the side characters' life kind of was like outside of school. You didn't really get to know them that well, so I didn't care for any of the side characters, and I barely cared for Pilot as well, our love interest, and I also didn't really care about Shane, because every single time that something came up which she wasn't super comfortable about talking, which could have given the character a lot more depth, she didn't talk about it. Now the non-spoilery section is over, and I want to go into more of the things that happened in the plot, in the story of Again But Better. So if you haven't read the book, and if you want to, don't listen to the next spoilery section that I'm gonna talk about. And if you want to like see the tea being spilled about the spoilery section and like the plot and what I thought about it, then just keep on watching. Okay, first of all, the Pilot Shane thing is all basically cheating without really doing anything. Pilot has a girlfriend back in the United States called Amy, and he basically kind of wanted to break up with her when he went to London.
and
Amy didn't really want to break up, so they didn't break up. From the moment that Pilot and Shane meet, they go out and do a lot of things together. I mean, you can do things with boys and girls if you are the other gender and just be friends. There was so much flirting and almost kissing that it's not okay. This book kind of made it look like cheating in a different country while your partner is somewhere else, even though you don't really want to be with them anymore, is like okay. That just didn't sit well with me. That was something that I really didn't like. Getting back to Shane's parents, I already like kind of talked about them in the non-spoilery section. They surprise Shane in London. They've been talking with her kind of through Skype about how things are going. Shane has been lying to her parents by saying that she's going to like a pre-med thing in London while she's actually doing the writing thing because she's so scared about telling her parents that medical school is not really her thing, and her parents practically force her to do it. That already doesn't sit well with me because I am a full believer of doing what you want to do and what you feel comfortable with. That already made me feel like ugh about the parents. But when they go to London and surprise Shane, the first thing that they want to do is take out all of her London friends out to dinner and like have a fun time. Some people in the London group already had different plans, but the parents insisted that they were gonna come with them, which made me feel like, oh my god, they think the whole world had to be adapted to them. They didn't just want to take Shane out to dinner, they wanted to get everyone, and everyone had to be there. Otherwise, honey, if you have plans, cancel them. It just didn't feel natural. It didn't feel good. If someone else's parents took me out to dinner and talked like that the whole time, I would be annoyed just the entire dinner. And then the worst thing ever is when they find out that Shane isn't doing like a pre-med program, but like a writing program. Her dad immediately, in front of all of her friends, calls her, "You little shit. Who talks to their children like that? If you love your children, I feel like you would not call them little shit in front of all of their friends." It just made me feel extremely uncomfortable, and I hated them so much. Oh my god, the frustration is building up. They didn't even listen to Shane when she said that pre-med was not her passion, that her passion is with writing. They didn't believe in her. He was like, "You cannot make a living out of that. It doesn't give you any future at all." They don't believe in their daughter, and they only want her to do things that they want her to do. After that, Shane stops her internship, even though she's still staying in London. And I was like, why, girl? Why? Even if your parents make you feel like crap and make you want to come back to the US and still do the pre-med thing, you could still continue on with your internship. I mean, you're still staying in London. Why stop? And from that moment on, she kind of loses contact with Pilot. Shane goes back home to the US. She hasn't talked about Pilot, about her feelings whatsoever. She didn't finish her internship. She's just going back to medical school, and then we follow her 6 years into the future in 2017. She has since gotten a boyfriend. She got engaged. Apparently she said yes, and the first thing that she does after she gets engaged is go to see Pilot. They haven't had contact in 6 years except for saying happy birthday. Apparently she has been thinking about him nonstop ever since she came back from London. And in my mind, I was just like, why do you have a relationship with Melvin if you have been thinking about Pilot the whole entire time? You do not get into a relationship with someone until you are done with the person in the past. It's playing with someone else's emotions. It's playing with your own emotions. It's getting yourself into a super complicated situation. It just made me feel like, why? Why? And why would she even say yes to the engagement? Oh my god. Then she goes to talk to Pilot. They go to a coffee shop and get transported some way, however, what the hell. They get transported to 2011 and start to redo the whole college in London experience. If I wasn't spoiled for this section, I would have completely reacted in like a different way probably, but now that I was prepared for it, I was like, okay. She and Pilot start to talk about their feelings eventually after basically like 6 years experiencing a different life. With this whole time travel experience thing and then Pilot and Shane hooking up and doing things, it is really strange. Like, do you see this as cheating? Because Pilot was basically still in a relationship with Amy, but it was a future person back in time. It was really complicated. It just felt so extremely strange that they were finally opening up about their feelings 6 years into the future, being transported back into the past, and then finally facing what they felt or are feeling for each other. Also, we finally kind of find out what the thing is with Shane and her cousin Leo, which I thought was just a strange thing into the plot. It could have been left out completely. Everything seems to kind of go well between Pilot and Shane, and then the last 20 or 30 pages, it's being thrown in that he broke up with Amy, but the message didn't get through the voicemail, and then Shane starts to have all of these weird feelings in herself, and she, again, is not talking to Pilot about the situation. She just doesn't speak to him for a month, 1.5 months, I don't know for how long, and she just does her own thing. And then all of a sudden, he starts to play guitar in Edinburgh? I don't know how to pronounce that city. He starts to play guitar for her because he's been following her in that city the whole freaking time. And then everything is well. They have a relationship. She becomes like a writer of like a book series. She's an editor for 17. And then they get engaged. Okay, fine, great story. I just felt completely frustrated the first like 200 pages of reading this book. I was just like reading every single page thinking like, oh my god, when is this over? In the second half, I kind of accepted the book, but I skimmed through all the pages. I didn't read the pages full out anymore. And I was just so happy that I was over with it once I finished it, which is not a good sign for reading a book. Now that I've talked about all of my feelings about Again But Better by Christine Riccio, I would really like to know if you've read this book, how you feel about it. Do you think that the kind of like 8 out of 10 rating on Goodreads is valid? If it's like a good representation of the plot and the story? Because I don't think so, honey. I'm sorry, Christine, if you are watching this video. I don't think you will. I'm sorry I didn't like your book. I really wanted to like it, and the first couple of pages, I was really excited, and I definitely thought that it was gonna be my cup of tea. Instead of it being my cup of tea, I'm now spilling tea. I hope you guys do not hate me for being so passionate about my opinion about this book, but I've just been feeling so frustrated, and I just had to share it. Even though that this was kind of like a rant video, if you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, and you can subscribe to my channel by clicking somewhere on the screen or on the button down below. All of my different social media pages are in the description bar down as well. I have Goodreads, Snapchat, Instagram, plus an email address, so links to that will be in the description bar. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope that I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!